Hello everybody, this is Matt Katz. I wanted to give you guys a different look at my living room, my apartment. But I want to talk about psychokinesis and why it has not been popularized sooner. One thing that I kind of think to myself, I've been thinking about it, is that why has psychokinesis not been in the mainstream sooner than what it should have been? Because if you think about it, in China and Japan and Asia, they've been practicing this thing called psychokinesis for a long time. And of course, this is a naturalistic thing that everybody can do. Everyone has the ability to perfect. But Asia, since they invented everything, paper and everything like that, fireworks and all that, they basically perfected psychokinesis, I'm pretty sure. Like, you know, they're probably the only civilization that has ancient texts describing how to move objects and how to connect spiritually with the living body, with physical external objects. They're the only ones, I believe. Asia, China, Japan, Asia itself is the only one that has these texts that teaches you how to do pyrokinesis, telekinesis, spiritual, and why hasn't psychokinesis become something that has been normalized sooner? You know, because when you really think about it, the Kui Gong exercises are the same as the martial arts exercises. You know, when they do that kind of thing like this, and they're going like this, and they're, you know, the chakras, and they're kind of like, you know, waving around and everything. They're kind of, you know, like the martial arts, you know, the martial arts teachers, they do the same thing as the Kui Gong teachers do. They teach the same techniques. And so in that manner, that simplicity, why hasn't psychokinesis become more bigger? You know, because we all know, you know, I know that in China, that in the cities and civilizations, they have these teachers that teach psychokinesis, that teaches you how to move objects, how to snuff out a flame, not just a normal flame, but a big old damn flame, man, with your fist. I've seen those videos where some guy is snuffing out a flame with his fist, and like, you know, like, why hasn't, because first of all, martial arts, you know, Bruce Lee and Jet Li and Jackie Chan, you know, first of all, Bruce Lee was the one who was a spearheader of all of that. Why didn't Bruce Lee bring along that psychokinesis aspect to his martial arts? Why didn't he popularize it? You know, that's the thing that kind of puts a question mark over my head, is that why didn't Bruce Lee do anything like that? Because like, he studied martial arts, he studied that, and martial arts is interconnected with the philosophy of spirituality, of the Asian culture, you know, the fighting. It's not just fighting, it's a yin and yang type of thing. It's more spiritual, it's more, you know, they're connected inward and outward. Why didn't Bruce Lee bring that? Why didn't he learn about that? You know, it was always there, but for some damn reason, since the 50s and 60s, 70s, 80s and 90s and the early 2000s, all the martial artists, Jackie Chan and Jet Li, never brought that stuff to America. Why didn't it psychokinesis hit? Why didn't psychokinesis hit us sooner? Because it was always there. It was always there. Some teenager or 20-year-old went to learn martial arts. But not only did they learn martial arts, they also learned about spirituality, their inner self. And within that consensus, they also learned about psychokinesis, telekinesis. It was always there in the culture of Asia, of China and Japan. It was always there. But for some damn reason, no martial artist ever brought that stuff to America to bring it to the light. That's also the thing that's kind of like a little bit questionable, you know, is that in the Asian world, in China and Japan, it was always something that was there, but for some damn people perform that stuff, moving things, setting things on fire, whatever it was. But for some damn reason, even the people that were in the country saw it. They saw things moving in front of them, but they just didn't like, you know, hey everybody, hey look at this, hey look at this, what the hell is this? This is fucking amazing, you know, this is fucking amazing. Hey America, hey, look at this guy, let's go make a damn movie about this shit. Let's go make a damn movie about this in the damn 50s. Let's forget about Bruce Lee. Let's go make a damn movie about some guy sliding a damn plate in a damn table. You know, like, why didn't Asia, you know, like why didn't the people who saw it, you know, why didn't they just grab it and run with it? You know, that's the thing that's kind of like troubling me, is that psychokinesis should have been popular since the first damn time that people saw it. But for some damn reason, the culture just didn't embrace it, and they saw it as just a gimmick. Why did they do it? And I think that it's because America had a big influence on that. America had a big influence on that. If America is not doing it, if America is not embracing it psychologically, emotionally, then there is nothing going on. When the Asians saw another Asian man, you know, setting something on fire or moving a damn plate on the table left and right, they saw it as just a gimmick, a big old damn gimmick. They didn't see it as something that was something real. They saw it as just like a trick, a magic trick, you know, and they didn't bring it to the light. And the reason why is because it's America. You know, first martial arts came, kicking in the air and all that stuff, but I mean, come on. You know, like they could have at least embraced this magical ability. I mean, someone is coming to you, an old man. I mean, in Asia, they respect their elders. They respect their elders, but yet for some damn reason, a damn street kid or a mother saw an elder moving something on the floor, and they still didn't accept it as something that was real. And they didn't spread the news. They didn't spread it around, you know? I mean, even there was documentaries from Caucasians from America. White people went to Asia, and they documented that shit. But for some damn reason, everybody was like, ooh. Everybody was just like, you know, like they turned their backs on it, you know? And all they wanted was punching and kicking and all that. They wanted punching and flying kicks. They wanted Bruce Lee stuff, but they didn't. But what's more extraordinary? A punch or a kick, or moving a damn cup on a damn table without touching it? You be the judge of that. And that's the problem too, is that, you know, I'm gonna try not to edit this video. I'm gonna try to just let it go because it's the first one. I hope you guys watched the whole damn video. But why didn't psychokinesis become popular long before? It was already in the culture of Asia. Asia, I'm gonna say it, that Asia pioneered psychokinesis. They pioneered that shit. Asian people pioneered psychokinesis, but the rest of the world, they were able to do it. Nina Kalagula was, you know, from a different country, Russia, Germany, can't remember. People can do it, but Asia was the one who pioneered the philosophy and the practice of mastering psychokinesis. They wrote fucking books on that shit. They fucking wrote books. You know, like, that's just the damn thing, is that they're pioneers, man. They're fucking, the Asians are fucking pioneers in that shit. They were light years ahead of every other race. But why didn't psychokinesis become more popular along with martial arts? Not only can you do a flying kick, but maybe you could set someone's tie on fire. Maybe, like, you know, there's a movie where, like, there's a villain and, like, Bruce Lee was able to go whoo and set his tie on fire, you know? You know, and then they do uppercut or something like that, you know? But that didn't happen, but that could have happened if Bruce Lee dug deeper into his culture and was much more behaved and well trained. You know, Bruce Lee would have been much more of an epic legend. But I guess it's all for a reason. And this is Mad Cat's Fear with why didn't psychokinesis become more popularized in pop culture sooner? Thank you guys for watching. God bless.